Today I'm going to do the Harry Potter tag. So I am so excited to do this tag, and I am really excited to get started. So let's get started with the Harry Potter tag. Number one, what is your favorite book of the whole series? My favorite book is The Deathly Hallows. Here's why. It has the most action, in my opinion. It has the best part of the conclusions, and it has all of the story connects, which is one of my favorite parts of the whole book series. And we're gonna have to do a take two because little Miss Kiwi just can't keep her butt off the counter. Number two, my least favorite book. I would have to say the first one. And the only reason I say that is because the beginning goes kind of slow at the Dursley's house. I kind of just, you know, like, I don't really like that part too much. And it just goes a little slow at the beginning. But I love the end of the first book. So that would be my least favorite. Number three, my favorite movie. Which one? Which one do you think? My favorite of the movies would have to be The Deathly Hallows Part 2. That's my favorite. I do like The Deathly Hallows Part 1, but Part 2 is way better, and I really, really love that one, and it's my favorite. This is what having a cat that will not leave you alone is like. Disappearo! Favorite movie, number 4. My least favorite movie of all of them would definitely have to be the second one. The second one, I think, goes a little slower, and I just don't like that movie for some reason. I don't know why, I just don't. That's my least favorite of all of them. I mean, I like the movie, but it's my least favorite out of all of them. Number 5, favorite quote. My favorite quote is Hermione's quote when she goes back into the girls' dorm, and she says, "Now I'm going to bed before either of you think of another clever idea to get us in trouble, or wolves expelled." Favorite. That was a horrible British accent, excuse me, but I love that scene. Best quote. Number 6, my favorite Weasley. It would have to be Ron Weasley, just because he is the match to Hermione, and that's why I like him. And yes, Kiwi is going to have to join me because she keeps jumping in front of my awesome set that I have set up here, and she will not be good, so she's going to have to join us on this magical adventure. Aren't you naughty girl? Number 7, my favorite female character. My favorite female character is Hermione. Of the main three, I like her the best. And I think she's strong and heroic, and I really like her. My favorite villain would have to be Snape. He's not really a villain, but he seems like a villain throughout the whole series. And I love Snape. Snape is awesome. And he's a cool, awesome character. Favorite male character? I would actually have to say Harry. Harry is a cool character, and I really like him, and I really like how brave he is and how he deals with real people's struggles. I really like him. Favorite professor? I would have to say McGonagall. She can turn into a cat. I love cats. Like this one. Are you secretly McGonagall? 10 points deducted from Ravenclaw. Thanks. 11. Would you rather A, wash Snape's hair, or B, listen to Lockhart talk all day? Wash Snape's hair, because Lockhart is, oh my god, so annoying. He's like petrifying. I hate him so much. Number 12. Would you rather battle Bellatrix or make Molly mad? I would rather battle Bellatrix, because if you haven't seen the movie, spoiler alert, Bellatrix actually gets killed by Molly, and it's because she like messes with her daughter. I wouldn't want to mess with Molly in any kind of way, so nope. Wash my hands of it. I'll battle Bellatrix. Come on, Bellatrix. Would you rather travel to Hogwarts via train or flying car? I would rather go in a train. The train looks so cool. It has that little trolley that has all the cute little snacks, and I have my pass. I have my 9 3/4 pass with my 9 3/4 little thing and my lanyard, so I'm all set to go to get on that train. I've just been waiting for it for my whole life. Would you rather kiss Voldemort or give Umbridge a bath? I would rather kiss Voldemort. Even though he's noseless and completely evil and bad, Umbridge annoys the crap out of me, and I would definitely not want to see that woman in that state. No thank you. Like, just
tunnel vision on that one.
Would you rather ride a hippogriff or a fireball? Fireball. I've always wanted to actually fly on a balloon like in Harry Potter, and I think that'd be stinking awesome if I could do that. But, you know, the creature would be cool too. 16. Different character, different from the movie to the book. I feel like they're not really that different from the book. I feel, in my opinion, that they're pretty similar. Some of the things that maybe I thought were missing from the movie that were in the book that were important were the parts with Remus and Tonks, how they got married and how they ended up having a baby, and how Remus freaked out and, you know, went to Harry and Harry yelled at him. I really thought that part should have been in the movie, but it wasn't, so that's why it's in the book, I guess. A preferred book, which I think I already kind of said, but Deathly Hallows. Richard Harris or Michael Gambon? I would say Michael Gambon. Even though Richard Harris was a great Dumbledore, that's the first one. I might be getting my name fixed up. I will always see Dumbledore as the Dumbledore that died in the movie, that actor. So that's what I'll see. Top thing that wasn't in the movie, as I just said, the Thompson bad stuff. Remake one movie, which I would remake Deathly Hallows Part 2, and I would remake the part to add in the clip of Remus and Tonks, and I would also add in a little bit more information on the twins' death, because I would really want to know, you know, about, like, you know, who found him and everything like that. I would really like to know more information about that. Excuse that noise. 21. Which house are you? I am a Ravenclaw. No, that's not an eagle. I'm a Ravenclaw, and it's actually kind of funny because Andrew is a Slytherin and my friend Sarah is a Ravenclaw, and I think that's hilarious because Slytherin is like supposedly kind of more evil in the movie, but they're not, like, the way that the author said them is that some of them are evil, but most of them aren't, you know, because most of them aren't even heard from, so I think that's kind of funny. But I am a Ravenclaw, thank you. Bookworm. Which class would you love the most? I think I would like the class where you can, transfiguration, where you can turn, objects into animals. Like, say, for instance, you know, where Ron turns his rat into a cup, but it has a tail, so I would love to learn how to do that. So I think I would want to take McGonagall's classes. Which of the three Hallows would you keep? Well, I have a bigger version of this, but this is the pen version. I would keep the Elder Wand. I think that'd be really cool to keep and to have. The Invisible Cloak would be cool too. The stone, I don't see the appeal in that, so I don't think I would keep the stone. I wouldn't want to have this for power, just because it looks stinking cool. That's why I would want to keep it. But probably out of all of them, the Invisibility Cloak, because I think that'd be pretty cool. Favorite out of Padfoot, Prongs, and Moony. Lupin is my fave. I really like him. He's really cool. Alright, if you were on a Quidditch team, what position would you play? One, I would want to be a seeker, because I feel like choosing this would be way easier. Well, maybe not easier, but I feel like I could focus on finding this while the other stuff is going on, and the other stuff is kind of rough, and I don't know if I could do that, so I'd rather be a seeker. Were you happy with the ending? I was not happy with the ending. I was not happy that they didn't give us very much details into the future of theirs. We just saw our kids going off. We don't know what their careers were. We didn't know what, like, how long they had been married. We didn't see a marriage or anything like that, or, like, you know, having the first kid and stuff like that. Even just, like, a tiny glimpse of it. But that being said, with what it was and how it matched the book, I was happy that it matched the book, if that makes sense. How much does Harry Potter mean to you? A lot. Me and my fiancé are kind of obsessed with it. We basically have a box behind me that's just filled with Harry Potter stuff. We just got our official Gringotts, like, letters that has a key in it and a vault and everything like that, so we're kind of obsessed. parts of the movie or book that made you cry. When Lupin died, and Tonks died, when Sirius died, those really made me cry. If you could be or meet with one Harry Potter character, what would it be? I would like to meet Hermione Granger. That'd be awesome. Favorite character? Hermione Granger. What would your Patronus be? I would like to think my Patronus would be a cat, because I would take a cat to Hogwarts. I'd be like Hermione and take a cat, and specifically, I would take one cat. I think this one. I feel like she'd be a really good Hermione. One Jack. Now, the only reason that I wouldn't take Jack along with me is he's a little bit older, and he wouldn't be comfortable, and he doesn't like people like Kiwi does. Kiwi likes people. And I feel like he would not be as comfortable going there. Kiwi, she would roam around that castle and talk to everybody, and she would be a lot of fun. So I would take Kiwi, little miss, step in front of my camera. If you could have a resurrection from Invisible Cloak or Elder Wand, which one would you choose? I already answered this one. Invisible Cloak. And the very last and final question, which merchandise have you purchased from Harry Potter? Well, I have the Deathly Hallows necklace, a two-set necklace, the little one. I have the Elder Wand in a pen, and I have another wand in a pen. I have the Snitch from Harry's first game with wings and a little pedestal. I have a whole bunch of wands. I literally have almost all of the characters' wands. This is a Death Eater's wand, a Death Eater's wand. You can see by the top. The rest of it is just pretty plain, but I have almost all of the wands. I have a Time Turner and one of the locket. Now I have the real locket and a fake locket as well. A platform 93/4 pass that includes a lanyard and a little key thing. I have a Gryffindor bag, a Deathly Hallowed notebook, Gringotts keys and letter, and two Gringotts keys that go to the vaults. And then I have a whole bunch of wands upstairs that I have almost all of the characters. Thank you guys so much for watching my Harry Potter tag. I'm going to be doing an anime tag next, just for Carol, because she really wanted me to do it. And I'm going to be talking about my favorite animes and doing a little anime tag really soon coming up. But first, before that one, the Hunger Games tag is going to be live soon, right after this one. So I'm going to be putting up two within the next couple days. This one is going to go up on Tuesday, and then the Hunger Games one is going to go up on Wednesday, and then the anime tag is going to go up on Thursday. So stay tuned for those. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all my little nerdy stuff and seeing my cat, because she's now sitting in the box where all of this stuff goes and sulking because she couldn't get in front of the camera. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. If you want to look up the tag questions, just type in Harry Potter tag. You'll get a whole bunch of different ones. I just picked my favorite one, so this isn't like an official tag questions one. So just look up your own questions. God stinking dang it, Kiwi. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we are out. You really got to do that? Really, bro? Oh, okay. Just walk away. It's not on time anymore. Cats. Behind the scenes. This is what I do for prep work for the videos. I clean this for work. Because trips. I'm even gonna clean off the chair. So this is a behind the scenes look at what we do to get prepped for our videos. So it is 11:04 at night. Just confirming, I usually start with cleaning off the counter and getting my props. So for tonight, my props, I have this beautiful dark wand and a box full of secret Harry Potter stuff. So you'll have to see the actual video to find out what is in it. I'm gonna be doing the Harry Potter tag, so it's not like a Harry Potter skit or anything, but I wanted to add some Harry Potter props. So first I start by cleaning up the surface, getting my props. Then I gotta distract that little one. So I usually open the window, turn on the light outside, get her all distracted, and then I have to tell my whole family.